United League. I every day expect an embassage from my Redeemer to redeem me hence.
No.
And now, in peace, my soul shall part to heaven, since I have set my friends at peace on earth. Rivers and Hastings, take each other's hands. Dissemble not your hatred. Swear your love.
By heaven, my heart is purged from grudging hate, and with my hand I seal my true heart's love.
So thrive I truly swear the like.
Madam, yourself are not exempt in this, nor your son Grey, Buckingham, nor you. You have been fatuous one against the other. Wife, love Lord Hastings, let him kiss your hand, and what you do, do it unfeignedly.
Here, Hastings. I shall never more remember our former hatred. So thrive I and mine.
Grey, embrace him. Hastings, on Lord Marquis.
This interchange of love, upon my part, shall be unviolable.
And so swear I, my lord. So swear I.
Now, princely Buckingham, seal this thy league with thy embracements with my wife's allies, and make me happy in your unity.
Whenever Buckingham doth turn his hate on you or yours, but with all duteous love doth cherish you and yours, God punish me with hate in those where I expect most love.
A pleasing cordial, princely Buckingham, is this thy vow unto my sickly heart? There wanted now our brother Gloucester here to make a perfect period of our peace.
And in good time here comes the noble Duke.
Good morrow to my sovereign king and queen and princely peers. A happy time of day.
Happy indeed, as we have spent the day. Brother, we have done deeds of charity, made peace of enmity, fair love of hate between these swelling, wrong, insensate peers.
A blessed labor, my most sovereign liege. Amongst this princely heap, if any here by false intelligence or wrong surmise hold me a foe, I do desire to reconcile me to their friendly peace. I do not know the Englishman alive with whom my soul is any jot at odds more than the infant that is born tonight. I thank my God for my humility.
A holy day shall this be kept hereafter. I wish to God all strifes were well compounded. My sovereign liege, I do beseech your majesty to take our brother Clarence to your grace.
Why, madam, have I offered love for this, to be so bouted in this royal presence? Who knows not that the noble duke is dead?
Who knows not he is dead? Who knows he is?
All-seeing heaven, what a world is this!
Is Clarence dead? The order was reversed!
Ah, but he, poor soul, by your first order died, and that a winged Mercury did bear. Some tardy cripple bore the countermand, which came to lag to see him buried. God grant that some less noble and less loyal, nearer in bloody thoughts but not in blood, deserve not worse than wretched Clarence did, and yet go current from suspicion.
A boon, my sovereign, for my service done.
I pray thee peace. My soul is full of sorrow.
I will not rise unless your highness grant.
Then speak at once. What is it thou demandst?
The forfeit, sovereign, of my servant's life, who slew today a righteous gentleman lately attendant on the Duke of Norfolk.
Have I a tongue to doom my brother's death? And shall the same give pardon to a slave? My brother slew no man. His fault was thought, and yet his punishment was cruel death. Who sued to me for him? Who in my rage kneeled at my feet and bade me be advised? Who spake of brotherhood? Who spake of love? Who told me how the poor soul did forsake the mighty Warwick and did fight for me? Who told me in the field by Tewkesbury. When Oxford had me down, he rescued me and said, dear brother, live and be a king. Who told me when we both lay in the field, frozen almost to death, how he did lap me even in his own garments and gave himself all thin and naked to the numb cold night? All this from my remembrance, Brutus, rest sinfully plucked, and not a man of you had so much grace to put it in my mind. Nor I, ungracious speaking to myself for him, poor soul. The proudest of you all have been beholding to him in his life, yet none of you would once plead for his life. Oh, God, I fear thy justice will take hold on me and you, and mine and yours for this. Come, Hastings, help me to my closet.